A very good morning to all of you and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And today we are going to create this house set dog animation in PowerPoint 2016 or 2019. However, you can also create this animation in earlier versions of PowerPoint as well. And let's get started with the wireframe view of this character here. And for that I will move to the second slide, and here you can see the wireframe view of the character. And for that you can also select all of the objects by pressing Ctrl A key and then go to the shape format, click shape fill drop down button and choose no fill, and then go to shape outline and choose black outline. That way you can see the outline view or wireframe view of the objects that have been drawn in the presentation. So after choosing no fill and black outline, you can still see this house head as a colored object. That is because it has been converted to a picture. So if I open the selection pane by clicking on the home tab and then click select drop down button and then choose selection pane, here you can see two different objects with the name house. Let me collapse all of these. So here we have two houses, one is that and second one is this, and this house has been converted to a picture later on. First I draw this house using the shape tool, then I converted it to a picture by selecting it and then click on the home tab and then click copy and then right click and choose paste as picture. That is because if I want to subtract a part of this house from right this position, I can't do that. Let me show you. If I draw a rectangle over this shape and later I want to subtract this shape from the house, and if I select the house then hold down the shift key to select the rectangle, and then if I go to the shape format, then you can see that merge shape is disabled because you cannot apply merge shapes on the grouped objects. That is why I need to convert this grouped object to a picture first, and then later I draw a rectangle over it, and then I can use the merge shape subtract command to subtract a part from the house. And that is because we have placed these eyes behind the subtracted area. As you can see in the original animation, I have placed these eyes behind this subtracted area. Okay, now the next important thing is the position of these objects. As you can see that nose is on top of all the other objects, then we have tongue, then we have house as subtracted picture and so on. So if I select this nose and place it sideways, then you can see that that nose was on top of the other object, and then come the tongue and so on. So that is the exact positioning of this object. As you can see that the face or eyes are behind this subtracted house here. So if I place this house on top, then you can see the objects in the background. Now we will talk about the animations. So here we go to the animations tab and then click on the animation pane. And this animation is inspired from one of the animation by Po Chuchut at dribble.com. And that is the original animation. I tried to replicate and traced all the steps here into PowerPoint, and I hope you will like it. So first of all, we will talk about the tail animation. And for that, if I select this tail and change the fill color, then you can also notice an oval here, which is grouped with this tail, and that is to create a custom anchor point. And you can watch my video on how to create custom anchor point and why you need them for more information. So let me undo this, and on tail I have applied the spin animation effect, and you can open the effect option property window by double clicking on an effect, and you can apply an animation by going to the animations tab and then click on the add animation drop down button, and here you can choose which animation you want to apply on the selected object. So if you want to apply spin, then just click on this effect and that will get applied to the selected object. So after applying the effect, you can modify the effect option property by double clicking on an effect, and here in the spin animation I am using only 5 degree clockwise rotation without any smoothness with auto reverse. And if I go to the timing tab, then you can see that I am using a very short timing of 0.15 seconds and repeating this animation until end of the slide and starting this with previous as always. So hit the OK key, and if I hide rest of the objects and show you only the tail, then you can notice the animation effect. It is spinning at 5 degree clockwise, auto reversing within 0.15 seconds. So next is the house. So I will hide rest of the object and will show you only house as subtracted picture. So here on the house we have applied a down motion path, a very short down motion path, as you can see the length of this path here. And if I open the effect option property, then you can see that I am using the default smoothness with auto reverse and a duration of 0.15 seconds and repeating this effect until end of the slide. So if I show you the slideshow, then you can see that this house is moving up and down very fast and repeating until end of the slide. So the same animation has been applied on many of the other objects. If I turn on show all, then you can see that on the nose we have applied the same motion path. And you can do that by selecting the house first and then go to the animation tab and then click on animation painter once, and then you can click on the next object on which you want to replicate the same animation effect. Like on the nose, if I click on nose, then the same animation effect will get replicated. So the next animation effect is on body, and for body we are using the grow shrink animation effect with 102% only horizontal growth with auto reverse and the same duration timing 0.15 seconds and repeating this effect until end of the slide. Hit the OK again, and if I show you the slideshow of only the body part, then you can see it is expanding and stretching very fast, and that is to create a movement in the body as the tail is also shuffling up and down. So the body should also have a little bit movement. That is why we are using the grow shrink effect on the body. Okay, now the next part is the tongue, and for the tongue we are again using the grow shrink effect with 105% horizontal, a little bit more growth than the body with auto reverse and a duration of 0.15 seconds and repeating this effect until end of the slide. And that way the tongue will also have a little bit motion. That is because the head is moving up and down, so there should be a motion in the tongue as well. So here let me correct one thing. Here we have two houses. One is the house and the next one is house as subtracted picture that I have shown you before. So if I remove this house here, then you can see the subtracted house and the eyes behind that house. So we have used the same animation motion path on the house, and you can also move the animation effect in the list. If you want to move that animation on the top, you can just drag and drop it in the list. Okay, now the next part is the shadow of the house. I have drawn this shadow separately, and on the shadow of the house we are using the same grow shrink and motion path animation effect, and you can use the animation painter to replicate the same animation on the house shadow as well. And for the eyes, and here is the important part, the eyes and the house. So if I hide rest of the object and show you the subtracted house and the eyes, then you can see that those eyes are behind this subtracted house. So on the eyes we are using the left motion path, and if I show you the effect option properties, you can see that I am using the default smoothness with auto reverse and with the duration of 1 second with the delay timing of 0.05 seconds and repeating this effect until end of the slide. So let me bring all the objects and hide this house. So as you can see that we only use three animation effects, spin, grow shrink and motion path, to animate this dog here. The only time consuming part was the graphic designing of this character. And I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video, and do subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for your time and have a great day.